never show the world, but no one knows your name yet. You wonder when and where and how you're gonna make it. You know you can if you get the chance. In your face and the door keeps slamming. Now you're feeling more and more frustrated, and you're getting all kind of impatient.
It's me again. Today is day 3 of my water fast, and it's September 4th. Today was a little harder than the other 2 days. I decided that I needed some human interaction, so I decided to hang out with my husband, and instead of just hanging out with him and enjoying his company, I started spouting off a lot of the stuff I read, and he can only handle so much knowledge at a time with regard to health and fitness until he gets bogged down and just wants to give up on eating healthy and doing all that stuff. So that kind of got us at each other's throats. And I feel really bad because we hadn't really spoken much in the last couple of days. So that's today, and it caused a lot of emotional hunger for me, because as you must know, maybe I didn't say it before in any of my videos, but I was a binge eater before I started on the raw food journey, and my first response to any sort of conflict or any happiness or any sort of reward would be to eat something. So, of course, out of sheer habit, my stomach would start growling, and I got a slight headache today, which is normal with detox anyway. And of course, like I told you, I was starting the distilled water, so that was different as well. One thing I am noticing, though, with the distilled water is kind of like salty mouth and a salty lips. So maybe that's just like the sodium's coming out, which isn't always a good thing, but not a bad thing either, depending on if there's an overabundance of sodium in my body. But yeah, so that's what's going on with that. I also read, we had a decent sized storm. It wasn't as big as they said it was going to be, but it rained quite a bit and stuff, and I went for my 10-minute walk as soon as I got up this morning, and then I decided I would go to the grocery store with my husband while he got his groceries. So of course that brought on some emotional cravings, because he ate bread in front of me, and then he made a chili today, and oh well, it's not his fault. He's got to eat. He's not the one doing the fast. I'm the one with the strength, the power, the mind knowledge to know that what he was eating would hurt me. And sometimes it hurts him, but he'll come to the realization at some point in his life that he can't be doing this stuff anymore. He's not really eating that bad, though. He's eating quite healthy in comparison. Like, he's not eating pizza, and he's not eating a bunch of burgers and cheeseburgers, and he might have red meat once or twice a week now, so he's doing really good, so I can't complain. But yeah, tomorrow we're going to visit the in-laws, so hopefully that goes well. They're also having a dinner, so I'm going to try and preoccupy my time while they eat, or I might just sit there and talk to them and ignore the food, which probably would be a better idea. Anyway, the second book I read in the last few days is Water, The Ultimate Cure, by Steve Mayerowitz. There we go. Anyway, it was quite interesting. I found out that distilled water is definitely my best option. Not that I would go out and buy a distiller, but I will definitely go buy distilled water in a store. He does bring up a good point in the book that you should write the companies to find out their assay, which is basically the content of all the minerals and everything that's in it. Gives you a chemical breakdown. And he says to ask a few other vital questions too, such as, who does their lab testing? Do they do it, or do they have another company, another laboratory corroborating the results and stuff like that? So I'm going to plan on writing the brand that I bought and to see what they say about this. It will be quite interesting to find out the results. Anyway, so other than that, detox results, symptoms I mean, are really next to none. I lost another pound, so I've lost 43 pounds in total. I'm down to 165 pounds now. When I get to 160, I have a goal. I've decided that I'm going to buy one of Dan McDonald, the Life Regenerator, one of his plans, either the Juicing for Better Skin or his weight loss plan. I just wanna help the guy out. He's done a lot for me, just in his free videos, and I feel that donating to him and helping him continue his journey will make me feel good inside, plus I'll get the benefits of the knowledge that he's going to give me.
Let me down. I need you now to make it easy. Time ain't that
hard. And then when I get to 150, I'm gonna fit myself in these awesome jeans that I've been wanting to fit in since I was like 178 around wedding time last year. So yeah, there you have it. And of course I'm going to give to another charity, or maybe some more to Dan, and we'll see. But yeah, so every time I lose 10 pounds, I have a new goal. When I get to 125, I'm going to put a huge amount, depending on when I get to 125 pounds, I'm going to put a huge amount of money away for a trip to LA, or if it's in 9 months or so, when we have some extra money, we're just going to take it and go on the trip right away. So anyway, thanks for listening, guys. I'm sending you lots of love, joy, peace, happiness, and light and positivity. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I hope you're all doing well with whatever it is you're concentrating and focusing on right now. But yeah, talk to you soon. Thanks, guys. Namaste.
You know I know how to make them stop and stare as I fall out.